I told myself I wouldn't be buying any more ships, even at this latest International Aerospace Expo. But I couldn't resist just the tiniest purchase for what's come to be one of my favorite ships. That's right, with the polar paint on my Prospector, I'm back in the mining saddle to go see what new mineable things there are to find. As a little backdrop, this isn't the first time I've gone to Hurston to try to find some mineable rocks. After Hurston was introduced into the verse, and then after hand mineable rocks came on the scene, I did get curious about whether these hand mineables, or other type of mineable rocks, could be found on the actual surface of the planet itself. Back when both of those things were first introduced, I did find a few hand mineables on Hurston, but couldn't locate any of the ship mineable rocks. The moons of Hurston are well known to be good mining locations, but I've always wanted to find things on the surface of the planet itself. When Microtech was introduced, CIG immediately seeded the surface of Microtech with all kinds of different rocks. There were both hand mineables and ship mineables scattered all over the surface, and were in a wide array of both value and concentrations. You could find 12% quantanium, or 12% quartz, and the size of the rocks also covered the full spectrum of what I've been able to find. But what is there to find on Hurston? With each patch, CIG often introduces little changes that don't necessarily make it on the roadmap, or even get mentioned in patch notes. So with the introduction of 3.11, I started to get curious about if any changes had been made on Hurston. Now, if you think about the Stanton system in terms of actual planet-side mining, the options are somewhat limited. Arcorp is a city planet that at least currently doesn't have any open ground where you would find rocks for mining. Orison is going to be essentially a city in the clouds and is obviously not a place where you're going to find any rocks on the ground. So not counting any of the moons, Microtech and Hurston are really the only two choices for this true planet-side mining out of the four major cities that are planned for that system. And even Delamar, that has the borehole outpost of Levski, seems to be void of any mineables that are on the surface itself. Armed with my Prospector polar paint, it was time to spend a few hours searching on Hurston to see what I could find and see if they introduced anything with this latest game update. Right away, I started to get pings. It was definitely mineable rocks of some sort, but what kind were they? Well, I found Dolavine. And more Dolavine. And more Dolavine. In fact, I was usually finding Dolavine in fairly large clusters, 5, 6, 8, 10 or more, and wasn't finding much of anything else, except one lone rock of aphorite. But I'm not one to give up a search all that easily, and I noticed on my radar the little angle indicators that were showing some sort of object off at a distance, but wasn't putting the big glowing box around whatever it was picking up. So these things were worth some further investigation. As I approached, I started even wondering if it was mineable rocks at all. Perhaps it was one of the other harvestables CIG's talked about being present somewhere in the verse, the pintambu fruit, or one of the melons. Something else that the radar was picking up and could be gathered on the ground, but wasn't showing up on the radar in the normal way. The first one I came to, however, was simply more Dolavine. I checked out a couple more of these distant and somewhat unmarked pings, but they turned out to be the same. More Dolavine. At this point, I admit, I was getting just a little bit discouraged. I mean, is it possible that this huge planetary body had absolutely no ship mineables on it?
Oh no. We cannot allow ourselves to think that.
Now, I had heard about the lore of Hurston, a planet that had been pretty much mined out and stripped of its natural resources, leaving behind heaps of tailings and trash from abandoned mining efforts. Even the overall topography of Hurston shows these stair-like rings of depressions on the surface, showing that it had been mined layer by layer into pits. But I couldn't help but think that even with this history, surely...
And don't call me Shirley.
There must be a few rocks left behind. A few discarded remnants. Something overlooked somewhere on the entire planet. So my search continued. And indeed, I found a lot more Hand and ROC mineable rocks. In fact, there was a lot of them. And it occurred to me from looking at the surface of this planet that, by and large, it had a lot more open and free space from obstacles than I'd seen on any of the other moons. I realized that even though I wasn't finding any ship mineables, and so far only Dolavine, if a person or small team decided to take out across the surface of Hurston on a massive ground mining expedition, they'd probably have a lot of luck traveling and navigating anywhere on the ground that they wanted to go, and be able to pick up a lot of these mineables either by hand or with the ROC. I know the most popular way of using the ROC is to load it into the back of a Cutlass or some other ship able to carry it and move it around, and simply land and then pull it out when you find something to mine, which is a perfectly good strategy. But if an org or individual wanted to do something a little different, they could probably form up a ground mining team and go on a longer foraging trip on the surface of Hurston. Maybe a little better than they could on some of the other moons or Microtech. But then it happened. After finding a lot more Dolavine, I got a big ping. One of the large boxes that appear when you detect one of the larger rocks that you can mine with a ship. I thought, finally, I've done it. I've found the missing rock on the surface of Hurston. The lore was right in that it was a rare find, but not entirely absent. And this elation only heightened my sense of disappointment when I realized I had traveled so far from the original outpost I had used to quantum down to the surface that I had actually stumbled across another outpost here at Hurston. This was a major letdown.
Unacceptable.
I really wanted to find something to mine with my prospector on the surface of Hurston. The polar paint had so far brought me a lot of luck finding great rocks in other places, and I thought there must be something here. Anything. But at this point, I finally decided to concede. After hours of searching the surface, I wasn't going to find any ship mineable rocks on Hurston. Now, call me hopeful, but even now, saying this in the video, I still have a nagging feeling I can't be sure. You've heard me say before that just because you haven't found it doesn't mean it doesn't exist. And even though I had traveled far and searched for a few hours, in reality, I had only covered a small fraction of Hurston. Is it possible that a ship mineable is out there somewhere? Is it possible that with the many tweaks and updates CIG does with each patch that some might get introduced in 3.12? Well, I don't have any of those answers, but I do know this. I'll be back here to do more scanning and searching after the next patch, and we'll probably enlist a couple people in the science division from the good folks of Reed to help cover a wider search area, and maybe, just maybe, we'll find something. And don't forget to check out the Reedcast podcast, available at the link in the description.